Hello students, I hope all are safe and doing good. Myself Dr. Dakshani, working as an assistant professor in Government First Grade College, Rajajinagar. So in this slideshow, I'm going to discuss about the last unit of management accounting subject, that is regarding management reporting. Now let us move on to the contents of this video. So firstly, we are going to discuss about the meaning of management reporting, then objectives of management reporting, modes of reporting, kinds of reports, then principles of a good reporting, and lastly, the drafting of reports under different situations. So we'll move on to the meaning of management reporting. So management reporting is the organized, formal and comprehensive system which provides the management with the information needed to administer the organization. So it can be considered as organized form, and it is also a formal way and also a comprehensive system which enables the management with the information needed in order to administer the organization. So what are the objectives of management reporting? The first objective is management of reporting. It provides relevant information to the management. So as I have already discussed in this chapter, that management accounting is tools and techniques of management accounting. It mainly serves the information that is required by the management. The second one you have is management reporting provides information to the management which are needed to administer or to supervise the organization and to perform all the managerial functions like planning, organizing, controlling, etc. So even these functions of managerial functions also I have discussed in one of the main functions of management accounting. So it provides information to the management which are needed to administer the organization and to perform all the managerial functions like planning, organizing and controlling. The third one you have is management reporting helps the management to take sound and timely decisions. A sound and timely decisions can be taken by management with the help of management reporting system. Then you have the reports help the management to measure the performance of the business and employees as well. So management reporting helps the management to measure the overall performance of the business and also the employees as well. So now we have modes of reporting. Report to the management may be presented in any one of the following forms or the ways. The first one you have is written reports, and second one, the reports may be submitted in the form of graphics, and the third one you have is oral reports. Firstly, we'll move on to kinds of reports. Under that you have the first one is classification of reports according to the purpose. And second one you have is classification of reports according to the period of submission. And the third one you have is classification of reports according to function. Therefore, from this it is very much clear that reports can be broadly classified into three categories. Firstly, on the basis of the purpose. Second one, on the basis of period of submission. And the third one you have is on the basis of function. So let me discuss the first classification, that is classification of reports according to the purpose. According to the purpose, we have two types of reports, that is external reports and internal reports. What are external reports? External reports are those reports meant for persons outside the business. Like for example, they are called as external stakeholders. Who are those stakeholders? Like for example, you have suppliers, financial institutions, so various banks and also the customers, etc. And the second one you have is internal reports, and these are the reports which are meant for different levels of management. That is, you have top level, middle level and lower level management. The second classification would be classification of reports according to the period of submission. According to the period of submission, the reports can be broadly classified into two categories, the routine reports and special reports. The first one you have is routine reports. The name itself says routine reports are periodical reports which are covering the which covers the normal activities of the concern. That is, it is prepared periodically. The second type of report you have is special reports. These reports are prepared which as per the requirements or in order to serve the specific purpose of the management. The third type of classification is classification of reports according to the function. So according to the function, the reports can be classified into two categories. The first one you have is operating reports and second one financial reports. Operating reports are those reports which provide information about the operations of the concern at different functional levels. That is, operating reports can be broadly classified into three kinds. First one you have is information reports, second one control reports, and third one venture measurement reports, that is business measurement reports. And the second type you have is financial reports, and these reports provide useful information about the financial position of the concern. That is, you have static reports and also dynamic reports. Static reports are those reports which remains constant, which cannot be changed, and whereas dynamic reports are those reports which can be changed as per the requirements of the management. Now we'll move on to the essentials or principles of a good management reporting system. How a management reporting system should be? The first one you have is it should be a good form and content, and it should be simple and easy to understand, and it should be serve the purpose of the management, that is purposeful, and it should be prepared in time, and it should ensure accuracy. What do you mean by accuracy? Correctness. And then it should help in comparison, making comparison of the current data with the previous data, which enables the management in taking some important decisions. And next one you have is it should serve the purpose of different levels of management, maybe a top level, mid level, and also a lower level management. And the last one you have to keep in mind the cost involved in preparing the reports. So now we'll move on to drafting of report. So these are the four things that you have to keep in mind while drafting any report of a company. The first one you have is address, the subject, the body of the report, and also the signature and the date of the report. So this is a specimen of drafting a management report. So the specimen goes as follows. The profits of Bhaskar Limited is declining year by year. So you as a management accountant are supposed to draft a report to the management explaining the reasons for declining profits and suggest corrective measures. So this is the name of the company and also the address that you are supposed to write. And towards your extreme left, okay, you have to write a person whom you are addressing, that is to the managing director, and the name of the company. Then you have respected sir, and also towards your extreme right, you have to supposed to write the date. Then the subject. The subject would be a report for declining profits. So now what is the matter? So as per your instructions for ascertaining the reasons for declining profits of a company year by year, I submit year under the reasons for declining profits and my suggestions for addressing the decline in profits. So what are the two reasons? That is, reasons for declining profits may be due to lower sales or higher cost. And one more thing you note down, students, there may be more than one reason or two reason apart from these reasons also. So if you have highlighted any of the reasons other than these two, okay, you can just mention in the report. And then finally, for the reasons that you have mentioned, okay, for the reasons that you have mentioned here, you may give the suitable suggestions to the management, which enables the management to overcome the decline in profits. So the first reason that we have given is lower sales. So how you are going to overcome this? That suggestions may be to improve the sales. How you are going to improve the sales? It may be either by improving the quality of the production. And the second one you have is the higher cost. So higher cost can be attained by reducing the cost of production. What may be the main reason for increase in cost of production, students? It may be either due to increase in transportation cost, okay, and then production cost. So all this can be reduced. And one more reason may be your promotional activities to promote your product may not be good. So increase your promotional activities. So these are the suggestions that can be given by the management accountant addressing the problem. Okay, so finally you are supposed to write yours faithfully, and then your name, and then your designation, that is management accountant. So this is a specimen for drafting a report. So here is the previous year question, students. So which was asked in section A and section B. So state any two uses of management reporting, objectives of management reporting, meaning of management reporting, then the two requisites of a good reporting system, which I have already explained in the previous slides as such. And under section B, they have asked you to draft a report about the decline in that is a management accountant of the company, draft a brief report to the management explaining the reasons for the declining sales. The sales may be decreasing, so you may have to give the reason as to why there is decrease in sales, and also what are the measures or the suggestions that you would like to suggest the management, being a management accountant. So I have given you the specimen. According to that, you are supposed to draft a report. And then the second question you have is ABC Company Limited is facing the problem of shortage of working capital. So as a management accountant, you are required to draft a report to the management explaining the reasons for shortage of working capital. So here also you have to give the reason as to why there is a decrease in working capital. There may be n number of reasons. Again, here students, you just note down a decrease in working capital may be because of more investment on current assets, unless that is you have the sources available for the purpose of raising current liabilities may be very less, but the investment on current assets may be more. And one more thing, while discussing in the ratio analysis, I told you about the current ratio. What is the standard current ratio, students? It is 2:1, which means that for every 1 rupee worth of current liabilities, an organization must have 2 rupees worth of current assets, which means that this ratio ensures that the short-term solvency position of the company is satisfactory. So find out the reason as to why there is a problem or a shortage of working capital. Sometimes an organization may make use of the fixed liabilities in order to finance working capital, that is in order to ensure that sufficient working capital is required. Or the other reason may be that in order to finance fixed assets, the company may make use of working capital, but at any cost, fixed assets cannot be financed out of working capital. Why? Because the very meaning says that working capital is the capital which is required to meet the day-to-day activities of the company. So in this way, you can just analyze the situation and then identify the reasons for shortage of working capital, and if possible, you can give certain measures or suggestions to the management as to how they can overcome this shortfall of working capital, students. So now I'll move on to the third question, that is the profits of the company are declining year by year, and as a management accountant of the company, you are required to draft a brief report to the management explaining the reasons for declining reports. And this specimen I've already discussed in my previous slides, student, with the example. There are two reasons for the decline in profits. It may be decrease in sales, or it may be either due to increase in cost of production. So this is how you're going to prepare a report and submit to the management. Hope I think you all have understood how to draft a report. Thank you, students. I hope this chapter is very much clear to you. So the only thing is they are going to ask you only for section A and section B, and if possible they are going to ask you to draft a management report giving a particular situation. So just keep the content of the report as I have already told you, that is the address is very much essential, then subject you have to mention, then the body of the subject that you are going to address to the management, and then finally the greetings. Okay, so with this I am going to complete this chapter, and all the units of management accounting subject is completed. So I hope all of you have completed working out problems on ratio analysis, students. Though there are n number of formulas in the chapter, please do remember that working out the problems under ratio analysis is as simple as such when compared to other chapters. So I want all of you to attend this problem at any cost in your exam. Why? Because it increases the knowledge of the students. And one more thing, when you attend any interview, they are going to definitely ask you about the ratios. Okay, so you must be perfect in those ratios calculation also. So one thing, always we have to study the subject not only from the point of view of examination, but from the point of view of gaining the knowledge. Okay, so I wish you all the very best for your exams. Thank you, students.